Today I am going to discuss the Davinci Resolve. This is one of the most attractive software available in the world for the video editing. Basically this software is made by the experts for advanced 4K resolution video editing. And one of the very good thing about this software, that's why I like, is that it is very professional, advanced and free. Another big advantage is it is for Windows and Mac, one software will do. There are many software which is only compatible to the Windows and another is not compatible with the Mac. So if you learn it, it is very difficult, because if you are shifting to the Mac, it will be difficult. It has color correction, video in video, fusion, and very advanced editing. And moreover, it is 4K. So 4K means that is ultra high definition. Nowadays, the laparoscopic videos are available in high definition. But now the new company is coming with the ultra high definition. This camera, like Olympus has already launched the 4K camera. So if you are buying it, better to buy 4K. Like TV also, if you buy now in your house, you should buy 4K TV, not HD. HD is obsolete, 4K is ultra high definition, that is 4K. So it is completely 32 bit and very advanced. Now, another good thing about this software is that later, if you want, you can go to the studio version. DaVinci Resolve alone is free. But suppose you have a passion about video making, you want more advanced, then you can buy it for $299, that is DaVinci Resolve Studio. Although it is not necessary, most of our work is done by the DaVinci Resolve itself. You don't need a studio version. So I am going to demonstrate you how to use it. Once you open this, when I click it, it will open. And then on this panel, it will ask you want a new project or you want the existing project to open. So I am just for demonstration giving you new project. So I am opening a new project and it will open like this window. This is the first window and it is untitled project. Later, once you save it, you have to give a name. On the bottom, it has a different windows. This is media window. This is editing window. This is fusion window. This is color correction window. This is sound window. And this is save window. This is audio window. And this is save. Save means final exit. Yes, you can go back in any window. Any window. No, all the work will be saved. Even with the one window you go to another, your work will be saved. And time to time it is auto-saving. Automatically it is saving it, automatically also. Just like Word. If you are typing something in the Word, even if you don't save, Word is auto-saving it. So, what is this media pool? That this is your storage. And of course, for making any video, the first thing you need is that you should have video. And to have video, you have many options. As I told you earlier, you need a hardware. And there are many hardware. One hardware that is the best is Ekegami laparoscopic recorder. This is, you can say, video recording system, and it is available, digital recording, and you can buy it from the different sources, but it will be more expensive. If you buy this one, it will be more expensive. So the best thing I told you, that for laparoscopic video purpose, the best thing is Evermedia. Evermedia you can buy, these are Evermedia. And it is only 10,000, some are 11,000, and it is computer free. And some of them are so small that you may carry in your pocket. And it has all the input, HDMI, SVGO, and it you can attach the your flash drive also. If you don't want to spend money and you have a very normal, just you want for patient, giving to the patient, you don't want academic purpose, then it is EasyCap. EasyCap is extremely cheap, only 500 rupees. But one of the problem of the EasyCap is that you need to have computer. And you have to bring your laptop in the OT, and it has two parts. One is USB, this will go to your laptop, and another end has SVGO composite that will go to the camera. And it will directly transfer the camera, all the data to your laptop. So it has the only this problem, that laptop is required, and generally we don't want so. Another, if you want the best in the market, then you have a Striker video recorder. This is available, digital documentation system by the Striker. You can buy this, but cost is 4 lakh rupees, this one. This is revolutionizing the surgical documentation. And you know, it has inbuilt hard disk. And you can give your data to the patient in the CD also, in the pen drive also. And it has a patient documentation. You can write the pathology, you can write the... So this is also, this is, you can say, one of the best. But it is not necessary, because unnecessarily it is 4 lakh rupees, and the quality of the video is similar to the Evermedia, not to the EasyCap, but Evermedia, because this is also full HD, complete high definition. So it is full HD quality and 1080p, and it's very good. Do you know, this is basically made for gamers, like children who play the game, they record it. But you can exploit it, you can use it for your purposes. So first thing, you should have this data, because if you have data, then only you can edit. And once you have a data, after that you will bring and you will search your data from here. Like we can see here, we have the different drives, like D drive, C drive. Suppose I am going to one of the drive, and suppose this is the drive. Now I am going to users. Now you go to your, and here I am going to, let us assume that we go to my document. This is okay, documents. This is documents, and then you go to my document. This is my document. Then this is training, then this is TLH, PQR, this is TLH, total laparoscopic hysterectomy, and now you have all the videos. So this is browser actually, and don't ask me that what is browser, because browser means it will, and you can, wherever you will keep the mouse, it will show you the preview of that video. Can you see that? So you can go and you can get it here, like suppose this is the different, and I will take any of the, suppose TLH in 15 minutes, okay? and I'm dragging it here. Now it is asking me that the, you know, this is 1920 to 1080 frame. You want the same frame or you want to change? You will see that don't change, keep it same.
Why?
Do you know, suppose you have 1920 by 1080 picture, and if you want, you can make it 4K also. You may enlarge it or you can compress it. So this is your setting, metadata. Can you see that? And here if you see, this is 1920 to 1080. That is full HD. So I'm keeping it to the full HD. Okay? So now it is there. And here simply you can play it. And it will play with the sound.
Good assistant to use the colportomizer so that it will...
You have a sound also. And if you want, you can listen the sound.
In the center.
If you want to play,
good.
You can play it back. You got it? Or you can stop it. So this is preview, and here is your data. If you want few more, you can drag this also. As many as it. So this is basically your container. And as many video you want to be used in that video, you can collect it. Media pool, this is done. Now you go to the edit. There is one more way of bringing it to the media pool. What is this way? That directly go to the file here. Just open your any file. You got it? And directly go to the folder. And directly copy it. Like here, copy, and directly you can go and paste. Control V, and it will come there. So this is one of the way. Third way is that you can go here, and in the file section, you can import the file. You got it? And then you can browse it from here. So all the methods are similar method. It is up to you. You can use any method. So this you have to do. After that, you go to the edit. Here is the edit. Now in edit mode, it will show you your two projects. Isn't it? And if you will see mouse, I am moving the mouse here. If I am moving the mouse, it is running. So it is running. Can you see that? Here. I am moving the mouse and it is giving you. And if you want, you can play it also from here. You can select it and play so that you will get the idea that what is this, what this video. You can drag it also here and then you can play.
It's at 6 o'clock. You will have the midline, that is UV fold, and slowly
is it, clear?
It should move at 7 o'clock position. Harmonic is good instrument to separate.
Then just drag another one. That one will go. This is preview window. So now, once we drag this one, then first one will go.
Hit the peritoneum.
No, then go in the media and remove this. Just you go. And cut it. Yes, or backspace also you can give. It will delete. Do you want to remove the selected? Remove. Again, backspace. Do you want to remove selected? Removed. You got it? And if you want to bring it, again you can drag it here. Do you want to have different frame rate than the current project setting? No. Don't change the project setting. My project setting, again, I have dragged these two. Okay? So this is your, it may be hundreds of videos there. Like your intro, your outro, introduction about your hospital, your biography, your pictures, your son pictures, whatever. This is your ingredient. Just like when you want to make some chicken, you should have masala, you should have oil.
So,
no, audio also.
Audio and picture?
Picture also. Also picture. Like suppose you want a picture, you can put it. So suppose you want your picture, and here suppose this is the picture of any doctor. I will take it like this. You can just save image as, and you save it to the desktop. This time I am putting on the desktop, and save, and then you have it here. So you can drag it also directly from desktop like this. Here is my picture, and I can drag it here. See, I can drag it directly, and it came. So this is the picture also. So you can bring audio also, music also, whatever you want, any media, you can bring it. Now once you go to the edit, you will see all the media there. And if you click it, it will preview. And it will show you the property. What is the property? And you can play it also. How? Drag it here, and then you can play it. Okay? If you drag another, you will play it here. It is, and then again you can play it. Now suppose you want to cut this, because you don't want that it should be of Dr. Misra, you want your own. So you don't want this introduction, isn't it? So what you do, you...
Hello.
Stop. And there is a selection in. Click the selection in. And then play.
This is a case of laparoscopic total hysterectomy. This patient has been...
And then you can drag it also. See, I am dragging it. Dragging. Can you see that? Sorry. Let me do it again. This is, suppose this I want from here. I don't want this introduction. I want here. And then this you'd give the input. Input is here. And then play again. Play again.
Like Assure is used in this.
And output, you don't want this introduction of this also. You want up to here. This is the last suture, isn't it? Which is applied, and vault is closed. You want here only. And then give
this
output.
Was unedited now, total laparoscopic
close it. If you will put it here, you will see two files. One is video, another is audio. Of course, you don't want my sound. So what you do, you drag only the video here. And now, this is your final output. And in this final output you are seeing here, that there is no introduction. Did you see that? And there is no sound. You got it? This is one way of editing. There is no audio. You know, if you want audio also, I will do undo. Any time you want, Control Z means undo. Control Z, this is a normal command of the computer. Control Z means last command will reverse. And if you want sound and or video both, but if you don't want the intro, outro, which I have cut, then you can drag completely like this. So see, this is video, this is audio. You got it? Yes, that also I will show you. So now it is playing, and you can assure that it is. Now
like
suppose
assure.
You want to cut in the middle. Suppose you don't want to show the right side of salpingophrectomy. This is which side going on?
Is used in this
left
case.
Side. First you tell
only
me you want sound or not?
One
don't want.
Optical
okay.
Port.
Control Z, and I will drag only the video. Okay? And now I am playing it. And this is playing, and now we can, and you can drag it also like this here. Now see, this right side I don't want. So this right side I don't want. It is going. Left side I want. But it's a right side, I don't want, due to any reason, suppose right was not required, I did accidentally, okay? Right you don't want, then go back. Go back, go back, go back, and stop. Means you can replay it reverse also. If you click this, it will play forward. And if you click this, it will play backward. And there is a beautiful blade here. Can you see this blade?
Yes.
Just click this blade and go to this bar. You get it?
Yes.
And cut it. And now again play. See, this is the blade. Blade, blade, this is going on, going on. This I don't want, right side I don't want, I don't want. Now I colpotomy I want. Okay? So what I will do, I will cut it here again. So I have cut at how many places? Two places.
What the order you have to stop the cutting here? Because when I started cutting, then when you put the other line, it means automatically it will understand.
Automatically it will understand. Anywhere you will click, it will cut. Like a blade. Can you see this blade moving? Anywhere. Now, it is too big. I don't know where I have cut previously. Then there is a, here is a window. I am making it shorter. See. Now it becomes little shorter. Do you see that? So that it is manageable for me now. The strip is becoming shorter. Now if you see very carefully, here you have, I am dropping this blade. How to drop the blade? Click on this arrow. And blade is dropped now. Now see here, you have one video here, which you have cut. Can you see that? This is what? Right salpingeal oophorectomy. This is what? The left one. So you have three segments. One segment, two segment, and three segment. Is it clear? Which one you don't want? Means middle one. Middle one. Yes? So right click and cut. If you cut it, it is gone. Approximate. There are two ways of approximating. If you don't want to approximate, you want your picture there, let us assume. Then just drag this picture and put it here in between. Did you see that? Now you will see that once it will run, and once the left side is over, here it will show your picture. Did you see that? But if you don't want this, control Z, picture has gone. If you don't want, then what you do? You go, and when you have to cut it, control Z, when you have to cut it, right click and click the ripple cut. Ripple cut, what will do? It will cut also and it will paste also. Just like the sensor board, they do ripple cut. When adult scene they want, they cut it and it will join again. And that, any bad scene they remove. So this way ripple cut, you can do that. And if you want that to be filled by some other thing because it was important, like sometime in the movie, some important thing they cut, then they again do the shooting and they fill it up by some other, because suppose it was important for a story to understand, isn't it? And this you can bring from any other video also. Like suppose right side of salpingeal you make messy, and then any other video, you have hundreds of video, any other video there was no bleeding on the right side, you can cut it from there and you can put it. And your patient will never know that there was any bleeding also. You got it? But it should be similar looking, like, it is not like that uterus has a lot of fibroid. Obviously it will be visible. But similar you can do. So this is how you can cut any part, and this you can cut hundreds of times. Like I am stretching this now. See, I have stretched a little bit. And take up the blade and I am cutting, cut, cut, cut. Cut, 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 hundreds of times. I can cut so many times. See? Did you see that? All cutting with the blade. Cut, 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 cut. Thousands of times you can cut.
And how
Just you have to find out, go here, first let me remove the blade, otherwise, go here, can you see that? And right click and remove. You want to remove or you want to ripple remove? Ripple remove, that's all, done. You want to remove this, ripple cut, done. And see, it is becoming shorter. See, if you don't want this one, ripple cut, remove. If you don't want this one, ripple cut, remove. If you don't want this one, ripple cut, remove. Yes.
And if I want up to this, I want it to use
it. You want?
I don't want to use the knife up to here, but now it's already cut. How to stop this cutting? How to drop the knife? I need to play.
Okay, you go and press this. See, if you will press the blade is there. And if you want to remove blade, then go and press this arrow. And now blade is dropped. Now there is no blade in my mouse. You got it? Now I can only highlight it. And if you want, I can play it, this segment. See, any segment when I will click it, that segment will be played. You got it? This is called as timeline. Here is a timeline. This is timeline. And see, this timeline, you can drag it. Can you see that? And it is done. So you can do, suppose you want to cut again, remove and ripple cut, it is gone.
And now you want to write something.
Okay, that I will tell you. So now this, you understood how to cut?
Yes.
Any segment, you want this to be ahead, and another one should be before. Like suppose, here, this is what? How you will play? Bring the timeline here. And what is this? This is suturing. Okay? So I want this to be ahead like that. See? Now suturing gone at the end. And I want colpotomy after suturing. I can do that. See now, here what is there? That this is suturing. And after suturing you have this colpotomy, which you will never do. Can you see that? Here we are still dissecting the posterior peritoneum. And before that there was suturing of the vault. This you never do. But sometime we do. What we do, because sometimes suppose you are performing surgery and there was ovarian drilling, and you want ovarian drilling to show you in the beginning. And then you want salpingectomy, like here, suppose we have done the salpingectomy. If you want to show it from the beginning, you can drag that part in the beginning. And in the beginning, what we did, the suction irrigation to break those adhesions, we can cut that part. So patient will never know that it was done. Directly we will show the salpingectomy. You got it? So any part you can go ahead, you can bring it. But of course it should be justifiable. Like without removing the uterus, how you can close the vault? It should be justifiable. So this is now.
Excuse me, just about if I want again voice recording.
Yes. There are many ways of doing the voice recording again. How to do? I will show you. First let me make all the part which was cut, let me paste it, so that there should not be a gap. If the gap is there, what will happen? Black, yes. It will show you black. So first I am making all the part and making it sure that there is no vacant. Here it is, again I am dragging. This is no vacant now. Now, if you want the sound, a lot of ways is there to make the sound. It is very easy. Do you know, one of the ways is to spend money. If you want to give the money, you have to audio directly, you can record it. But that feature is in the DaVinci Studio version. A Studio version has $299. So the best way is that you go and put a sound recorder. Voice recorder, okay? Open the voice recorder. Here is your VAS recorder, isn't it? And now keep the mouse here. You got it? And now what you need to do is play this and keep on recording. Now just I am recording it now. So how to do? There are a lot of recording software in the computer which can record your video and audio both. So I am keeping it here now at this place, this window, and I will play the record. It is recording now, and I will play the video. Here colpotomy just started, this is right side, harmonic scalpel is doing the colpotomy, and this is skeletonization of the UV fold, and here this is the uterine artery and vein together with the ligature. It is cooking and it's going on. So this is a very good surgery, and this is the uterine artery which will be cut. So this way you have to keep on speaking. Now after cooking we have not cut it, because better to coagulate both the side of uterine artery first and then cut in the next time. So this is the posterior peritoneum of the right side. Harmonic is separating and one grasper is giving the traction so that accidentally vein should not be cut. You got it? And now you stop it here. Stop, and then you go and here also stop. Once you stop it, it will go give you the file. Here is the name of the file. Can you see that? And now this file I am keeping it to desktop and saving it. It is saved. You got it? Now this saved file, I can go to the, no, I don't want to save the project, it is done. Now you go to the desktop and this is your recorded file. Okay? Go to the media library and now it is dragging. Now go to the edit again, and this is you inspect it, and here we can see we have a sound also. I will play this. Now after cooking we have not cut it, because better to coagulate both the side of uterine artery first and then cut in the next time. Okay? So now what we will do? Yes. If you want video also you can take it. Drag it, audio video both, and put it here. It is done. Now you see what is happening. And I will play the video. Here colpotomy is start.
You know, one thing is happening. What is happening? That it is not showing you the, yes, it is not showing you the lower video. Control Z. Did you see that? So what you can do, you can drag it in separate window. Can you see that? Means I didn't put it over that. I put it away. And now if you will play it,
the video. Here colpotomy is started.
Here also it is not showing the lower one. So what you do, select it. Select it, and there is one inspector. Click this inspector and make this video smaller here. See. Did you see that? Can you see that?
Yes.
This video is smaller. And then you drag it this, yes, on the top. You can position anywhere. You can position right, you can position left, you can position in this corner. You got it?
Only mouse.
I am dragging it here. This is the position. And then you can rotate. I am position up, position down. Did you see that? You can put it in any position. So I am putting it in right upper corner. It has two advantages. One advantage, it has hidden my name also. Another, that you have your own voice and your own picture. You got it? If you want, you can crop it also. Isn't it?
You can opacity also, it means you can make it like this transparency also. So this will also be visible and the lower video will also be visible. Or you can make it 100% opaque. So it has a fantastic work, you can do this. You can rotate it also. Suppose you want to rotate, you can rotate it. You can flip it also. If it is showing to the left side and you want that it should be shown to the right side, that also you can do. You got it? How I will show you? Just let me correct it first. Anything reset, you can do reset from here. This is reset. And suppose you want to flip. See, it is flipped to the other side. And you want to flip upside down, you can flip it this way. You can crop it also. And this way you can make hundreds of videos. Suppose you want your logo to be here. Again you can drag this and you can make it video number 4. See, can you see that? And here is one of my video is here. This is video number 4. But it is not showing the another thing. Why? Size is similar. So if two paper is of same size, the lower paper will not be visible. So you need to go to the inspector. This is inspector. And click the inspector. And after that, you select it. And then you can make this again smaller. Did you see that? Now one upper paper is small, then only lower paper will be visible. If upper paper is larger, lower paper is smaller behind the upper paper, will the lower paper will be visible? It won't be visible. And again you can position it anywhere. You want, you can position it right. I am positioning it right lower corner. Right, and here it is going lower corner. This is lower corner. This is, suppose this is your logo of the hospital.
Or you, it
is up to you. If you, I will show you. If you want whole presentation, see this picture, you have to drag it whole presentation. Did you see that? If you want less, you can drag it less. If you want only 1 second, you can drag it only 1 second. It is completely up to you. See here, this is time written, timeline. And how you have to do, you have to go to the picture. And once I am going to the picture here, see this picture, automatically arrow will form. Did you see the arrow? And this arrow I can stretch it. See, I am stretching, and see it is throughout, up to here, last picture. And this also I can stretch. I am stretching, I can stretch it as much as I want. But video stretching has only one problem, that it will keep on duplicating. You got it? It will keep on copy, and then you can paste it. Paste, drag it. And you can drag it as many times as you want. You got the idea? So this way you can perform, and again I am dragging it here. Again, I am dragging it here. So it will, what will happen to this? This will repeat. But picture you don't have to, you will just drag it completely, it will go. So if I will show you here, now what is happening in our this video, that let us play. It is recording now. It is recording now, and I will play the video. Here colpotomy is started, this is right side, harmonic scalpel is doing the colpotomy. And this is skeletonization of the UV fold, and here this is the uterine artery and vein together with the ligature, which is good. Is it okay? So this is the basic, you will do cutting and coagulating, means cutting and joining. You can cut or join multiple times. If you don't want video, you want only audio, select the audio and remove it. Select the video and remove it. You can do it very easily, and it is easily possible. Now you will go to the color mode. This is color correction. This is fantastic. This feature of this software is that any color You can increase, you can decrease. See. And color, can you see the color is? Color. Here, suppose this is, you can pick up any color and you can increase the contrast, you can decrease it. And individually also. Right now I am doing only for this picture. And color of this adapter lagana padega. Color of this picture is increasing contrast, and you have the different gamma offset, then gain, and you can change it for any of the. You can check the media pool, and suppose you want main video color correction, huh? Now once you have corrected the color correction is not required always. It is only required in the situation where you have to do a lot of work. Now suppose I have done, then what you can do, you can, once you will close it, suppose I am closing this, it will ask you, do you want to save? I want to save. And you will save it as, like today is 25th and June, and it is saved. It will save in the its own folder, that is DaVinci project folder, it is saved. And once it will save, and it will take all the data from everywhere as a database. As a database means, it will not make a separate file. It will create a database. It will not make a separate file. And next time when I am going now, then I don't have to do anything, just you go to the DaVinci Resolve. It will open, and in the welcome window itself, it will show you your project. So suppose you are a gynecologist, you are doing sometime hysterectomy, sometime ovarian hysterectomy, sometime myomectomy. So for every surgery you can have one project. And necessary ingredient for making that surgery can be available in a project. Like suppose you have not closed the port, but if you want that, you want to show the port closure, then already you have port closure ingredient there. And you can pick up from here and you can put in that video. And it will look like that patient port was closed. And if you don't want to show, of course you cannot. And another advantage is that if you have saved as a project, then only the main video you have to change. Do you know, saving it as a project doesn't mean that it is saving it as a video. It is saving it as a raw file, as a project. So it is editable, it can be still edited. So once it will open, we will see that it has another good thing about this software is it is so popular and so strong, it is loading, that suppose you have how to add text in DaVinci Resolve. If you will just type, then hundreds of people are ready to tell you. Can you see that? Yeah. You have hundreds of YouTube video. And these are, you can use it as a tutorial.
Hello there. Today I'm going to be showing you how to add text to a video in DaVinci Resolve.
So don't worry. You are not alone learning this software. Whole world is learning. So you can get it there. Now, see, this is our 25th June project, isn't it? Now, I will click it, and this project completely, exactly same place where I have left it, it has opened. Same place I have left it. And if further work is necessary, I can do that. I can pick up, I can make the color correction, I can do anything. Can you see that? So, this is possible. Now, here, once you have done all those, now you go to the audio section. In this audio section also, if suppose final, if you want a stereo, this is sound, you can play the sound.
Side, harmonic is separating and one grasper is giving the traction.
And these are the audio level. If you want to decrease, you can add echo, you can remove the echo. You can do some tuning of your sound. If your sound has hoarseness, you can decrease it, or you can add it. If you want more bass, you can add. If the male sound, if the ladies, you can make it a little more soft. These are the things, and this is the recording option, stereo, mono, or if two sound is there, any sound you can delete it. Or if you want, you can add extra music. It is very easy, just go to the YouTube and find music free MP3 file, and it is available. MP3 downloader online. So suppose I will online free MP3 download site. Suppose I don't know, I have maybe in my computer itself I should have some. Let me go to the file and import media, and let me see if I have some music. So go to the music. These are narrations. New folder. This is music. Okay? So this music I am dragging here. It is done. And now I am playing it here. Okay? So it is tested. And now just you take this music and add it here, anywhere. I am adding it here. And add it. Yes, text I didn't tell you. I will tell you how to do the text. To text, you have to go and you have to here effect library. And this effect library, here is the text. You got it? And you will add the text here. And you can add the text like a video. I'm dragging it here. And now it will drag. Now you go to the inspector and change it according to your wish. Like I am going to this, I am bringing this timeline to the text area. This is the text, and selecting the text. Now, this is the title, written title. You can write anything. You can, here is the written title, but you can write anything. Like suppose Dr. R. K. Mishra. You can change the font characteristic from here. You have hundreds of font which you can select quality. You can change the design. You want bigger, you want a smaller. You can change the color. You got it? You can change the transition. Color is here. You can change any color you want. Suppose I want to change a color, I am changing to another color, thousands of color. Then you want it to act as a video. It can be act as a video. Like you can rotate, you can change the axis. Like it will go and it will run all over. The anchor point, entry point, exit point, you can do all the things. And then, if you want to position, you can drag the position up, position down, anywhere you want, or in the bottom, or in the middle. And then you can adjust the timing also. Timing means, and on which video segment you want, that also you can adjust. See here, this is the timing. I will click it, and I can drag it throughout like this. And if I will drag it throughout, it will remain showing you throughout. If you want only for 3 seconds, you can leave it for 3 seconds. So how much time it will stay there, that also you can adjust. You got it? And not only one, you can add as many texts. Like suppose I want over this clip. Then I can go and I can drag this text over this clip here. This clip. So now this timeline you have to bring it here. This timeline I am bringing to this clip, and you will see here title. So you have to go to the inspector And this title word you have to change into the word you want. And once the inspector will be clicked, then this title, I just let me select this. Yes. And this title I can change to the World Laparoscopy Hospital. World Laparoscopy Hospital. And it will show you only that much period of the time here. So you can do with the picture, without the picture, over the picture, or below the picture, in the middle, anywhere you want. And the timing also you can adjust a similar way. You have the scroll also. If you want the picture to scroll, you want to resolve, you want it to be like a shining, you have 3D color, 3D different type of effect. So you can do, you can add the different type of drawings. So these are the different effects which you can put it over. And video transition. Video transition means if one video is, you have cut 10 video and one video is stopping, another video start, then you can give an effect of fade or effect of shift. Like here, when I am changing it, ding, and it was a fade effect. Isn't it? And it was a, now sometimes there is a shift effect. So this type of wipe effect. Wipe effect will be like that. See, it is wiping. Can you see that? So here I am doing with the hardware, but in the software, these are the possibility that you can add any effect if you want. So there are a lot of things, hundreds of possibilities are there, and you should learn it slowly. You can do that. Now, one very good property I have not shown you, that property is to change the speed. Do you know sometimes what we do, right click, and you can change the clip duration or clip speed. So let me delete everything from here. I am deleting track. I am deleting track. Entire track is deleted. Now bring it again. This is TLH in 15 minutes. This was the main. I brought it here. Now if I want, just you go here and you can change the speed. Change clip speed. Now you can, this is 100% speed. Right now it is showing 100% speed. But you can change it to 200%. If you will increase the speed, now I will show you 300% and change. See, now you will see this video, it will run very fast. Can you see that? It is running faster. It is running faster. But that much fast running is not good, because people will know that you have done something bad, because that much fast surgery anybody cannot do. So generally, the speed should be, if you want to increase, maximum 150%. If more than 150% is bad. So I am, generally my videos are 100%. But in the beginning you can keep it 125%. That's all. Now change. Now you will see it will do little fast, but it won't look bad. And people will think that he is a experienced surgeon. His surgery is getting faster. Can you see that? This is 125% faster than the original video. So maximum 1.5 you can go. 200% anybody can appreciate that this is not the original speed. It is going fast. So 1.25 fast is okay. So any other question? You have to save it. How to save? Just go to the final window here. This is final window. And now you can final check it. That everything is doing fine. And then just go and you choose that which format you want. Like suppose you want YouTube, then YouTube is taking 2160, that is 4K, 1080, that is the HD and 720 is low HD. So you can decide which format suppose you want. Suppose I am giving 1080 format. Then it will ask that which file you want, video, audio or all. Isn't it? Then you will say that I want all. And after that, you will start tracking. And it will start you. You get everything, you find it and export video. Format which you want. Format, this is MP4 format. Codec which you want. Codec is that much. This is fine. Where you want. I want in C drive. C drive or D drive, whatever you want. You can select and then OK. And then it will start render QE. And now it will save. So